Hey there, Pittsburghers. This is Elaine Henricks, the Education and Outreach Associate with the Pittsburgh Water and Sewer Authority. When you think about where you live, your city, state, or neighborhood probably comes to mind. But did you know that you also live within a watershed? Everyone does. A watershed is the area of land that sheds water from rain or snowmelt into a specific stream, river, lake, sea, or even ocean. A watershed's boundaries are the hills, mountains, or other high points where the land slopes toward the water. Like branches of a tree, streams flow into rivers, and rivers flow into larger rivers. Watersheds can be very large, like the Mississippi River watershed that stretches from Montana all the way to western Pennsylvania and drains into the Gulf of Mexico. A large watershed may be made of many smaller watersheds, like how the Mississippi River watershed contains the Ohio River Basin, and the Ohio River Basin contains the Allegheny River watershed and the Monongahela River watershed. Watersheds can also be very small, like the 4 Mile Run watershed here in Pittsburgh, which surrounds Schenley Park and drains into the Monongahela River. I'm going to help you learn more about watersheds by showing you a watershed model that you can create at home. For this activity, you will need 2 sheets of scrap paper from the recycling bin, a watering can or spray bottle with about 1/2 cup of water, non-permanent markers in 4 different colors, and towels, old newspapers, or a tray to catch the water. Take 1 sheet of paper and crumple it up in your hands. Then open up the paper without flattening it fully and lay it on the towels, newspaper, or tray. You want the paper to have some low areas to represent valleys and some high areas to represent hills. With a blue marker, draw on the paper where you think the streams and rivers would be if this was a landscape. I'm drawing some of my rivers along the hilltops and others along the valleys. Let's check to see if we are right. With the watering can or spray bottle, make it rain gently all over the watershed model, enough to make the water flow down the hills. Did you draw the streams and rivers in the right places? Over here, you can see I drew some of the streams and rivers in the correct places on the low wrinkles in the paper, and some of them in the wrong places, like up on top of the hill. This is how watersheds function. The water is shed by the land into streams, rivers, lakes, and oceans. Crumple up the 2nd sheet of paper, then open it up again without flattening it. Draw some streams and rivers on the low wrinkles with a blue marker. Maybe include a lake or two if you want. Next, use a pink marker to draw in some towns, streets, houses, and businesses. With an orange marker, draw some construction sites and some exposed soil along the tops of the hills. Then, use a green marker to draw in some forests, farms, lawns, and parks. Once you're finished drawing, use your watering can or spray bottle to make it rain gently over your watershed. What do you see? I'm seeing the rivers and streams forming again, but I'm also seeing the ink from the other markers washing away into the water. That ink represents things left on the ground that are picked up by rainwater and end up as pollution in our streams, rivers, lakes, and oceans. This pollution can include oil from leaky cars, pet waste beside sidewalks, and litter on the street. When bare soil at construction sites and exposed hilltops is washed away into streams and rivers, that dirt pollutes the water and can smother fish and other wildlife. When it rains, any fertilizer, pesticides, grass clippings, or leaves that are washed away from lawns, parks, farms, and forests can also pollute streams and rivers. A little bit of litter on the street might not seem like a big deal, but everyone's pollution adds up as water flows through our watershed, down the Ohio River, to the Mississippi River, into the Gulf of Mexico, and to the Atlantic Ocean. We all can do simple things every day to help protect and restore our watershed, the rivers it flows to, and the ocean. Pick up litter and pet waste, make sure bare soil is covered, and clean up any grass clippings or leaves that might get washed away in a rainstorm. When you've got those down, brainstorm some more actions you can take and put them into practice.